worry the game's music's too loud, but if it's anything like Skyrim, I should be able to fix it in game. Go ahead and fix this. Some last minute stuff, and alright, so. I'm dumb. There we go. That's what I wanted. Alright. Hello, everyone. Welcome, welcome. We are going to be doing a brand new playthrough of New Vegas. I did try New Vegas late last night to make sure it would run. That's why it says continue. But I've never played this, so. Yeah, we'll see how it goes. I've never done much with the Fallout series except for maybe the mobile game Fallout Shelter. So I have a rough idea what the story is. But I got Fallout New Vegas. I have Fallout 4 and Fallout 76. But I wanted to start with the oldest title that I have. Which would be this one. I hope it's not copyright. That'd be really bad if that's copyright sounds. Like, oh, don't gotta worry about it anymore. Kind of reminds me of, like, the old PlayStation graphics.
War. War never changes. When atomic fire consumed the Earth, those who survived did so in great underground vaults. When they opened, their inhabitants set out across the ruins of the old world to build new societies, establishing villages, forming tribes. As decades passed, what had been the American Southwest united beneath the flag of the new California Republic, dedicated to old world values of democracy and the rule of law. As the Republic grew, so did its needs. Scouts spread east, seeking territory and wealth in the dry and merciless expanse of the Mojave Desert. They returned with tales of a city untouched by the warheads that had scorched the rest of the world, and a great wall spanning the Colorado River. The NCR mobilized its army and sent it east to occupy Hoover Dam and restore it to working condition. But across the Colorado, another society had arisen under a different flag. A vast army of slaves forged from the conquest of 86 tribes, Caesar's Legion.
Damn.
4 years have passed since the Republic held the dam, just barely, against the Legion's onslaught. The Legion did not retreat. Across the river, it gathers strength. Campfires burn. Training drums beat. Through it all, the New Vegas Strip has stayed open for business under the control of its mysterious overseer, Mr. House, and his army of rehabilitated tribals and police robots.
Mr. House? Okay.
You are a courier hired by the Mojave Express to deliver a package to the New Vegas Strip. What seemed like a simple delivery job has taken a turn for the worse.
Oh, well, game over, guys.
You got what you were after, so pay up.
You're crying in the rain, Pally.
Guess who's waking up over here?
Time to cash out.
Will you get it over with?
Maybe cons kill people without looking them in the face. But I ain't a fink. Dig? You've made your last delivery, kid. Sorry you got twisted up in this scene.
Yo, what's up, Raj?
From where you're kneeling, must seem like an 18-carat run of bad luck. Truth is, the game was rigged from the start.
Got back from work. Nice. Classified items added to inventory. Mercenary pack. Tribal items. I have no idea what these are.
You're awake. How about that?
Whoa, I'm gonna have to look my inventory there, as fast as possible to find out what the hell this all
been
is.
Out cold a couple of days now. Why don't you just relax a sec? Get your bearings.
Leaf venoms. Lightweight leather armor, sturdy caravan shotgun.
Can you tell me your name?
40-20 gauge rounds. What's my name? What's my name? It's a rock.
I can't say it.
Yeah, especially being like a Vegas style game. Your name?
I'm Doc Mitchell.
Can I,
go rooting around there in your noggin to pull all the bits of lead out. I take pride in my needlework, but you'd better tell me if I left anything out of place. How'd I do?
Yeah. Great work. I mean, it's stunning graphics. Stunning. Oh, wow. I think this guy's had a stroke. I'm not sure. Pterosaur. Oh my goodness. The Warhawk. I'll go punk and go Warhawk. Oh wait, I can. Gettysburg. See, why don't Skyrim have this kind of customization? Come on. Daddy-o. I don't know why, but I like the daddy-o a little bit. How many freaking beards and chins are there? or Daddy-O? Let's go Daddy-O.
That'll work. Right anyway. Stuff that mattered. Okay.
Does this rematch look better than my game, to be honest? I don't know, honestly.
We can get you on your feet.
It might be. I'll check Steam in a minute, maybe.
Good. Why don't you walk down to the end of the room? Over by that vigor tester machine there. Take it slow now. It ain't a race.
Oh my goodness. Okay, so I'm using a controller like I do with Skyrim. Paperweights. Oh. Don't mind me, I'm just gonna steal all your shit. Whoa. Broken, but can possibly restore a full functional weapon. Oh my gosh. I have grenades? Wait, what? Oh, okay, oh, goodness, this is gonna be hard. I don't like this. Anyways, I don't like this menu, but I know I have to get used to it. What do I have? Got a broad machete, clipboard. Finance clipboard, hot plates. What's DT and CND? Okay, I can enter third person mode with that. You're
looking good so far. Go ahead and give the vigor tester a try. We'll learn right quick if you get back all your faculties.
Okay. I gotta choose the stuff little by little. Okay. Perception, cowboy always knows when there's unlimited dynamite nearby. Explosive lockpick, energy weapons. Energy weapons? Okay. Accuracy, compass range. Unarmed health, resistance, survival. Barter speech, companion nerve. Science, repair, medicine, skill points. Guns, sneak speed, action point regeneration. All skills, critical hits, enemy mishaps. I don't know, it sounds like intellect and luck I want to go into, right? For guns and criticals. PC just to see your reflection. Do I max intelligence? Or do I max luck? Or do I split the difference? I'm gonna split the difference, I think.
Look at that. Maybe them bullets done your brain some good. Well, we know your vitals are good. But that don't mean them bullets didn't leave you nuttered in a bighorn and dropping. What do you say you take a seat in my couch and we go through a couple of questions? See if your dog's still barking.
Not me stealing all of his crap. jump, push Y. That's a jump? My god, Bethesda. Take all the docks, bullshit. Don't mind me, Doc. I'm just borrowing. I'm just borrowing things. Just borrowing a lot of things, actually. Paperweight? You don't need a paperweight. See, he wants. Ooh, baseball. I didn't take that paper away. A ashtray, pencils. Oh. Sorry, Doc. I got shot in the head and now I'm a compulsive thief. So, yeah, just. My bad. Let's say, did these items just respawn? Okay, so 10 isn't the cap, because it says 25 or greater in science. Okay, so... awesome. Sorry, Doc, still stealing all your shit. Oh, give me one moment. I want the knife, sugar bomb, pork and beans. Maybe I should win this strength. Cause now I'm over in comfort. Awesome. Okay, that's red, so I guess I can't do anything that's red without it considered stealing? Question mark. But if it's green, I can just freely take it because he's letting me freely take literally everything. Just to see your reflection. So do you even need paper? It's not like just borrowing things permanently. Exactly. Thank you, Raj. Look, at least you understand. Abraxo cleaner. Say so. I can steal the man's plunger. If he clogs his toilet, he is fucked. Wait, am I recovering health by drinking out of the toilet in that? Wait, is that what that was? Am I literally just slurping out of a toilet when I did that? Oh, man. I didn't know how bad down I was. Sorry, man, I'm gonna take your pressure cooker too. I'm gonna take the man's last beer. Holy crap. This guy is never going to help another struggling anybody ever again. He's going to help me, I'm going to leave his house, and then he's going to be like, where the hell did all my shit go? And I'm just going to be like, I don't know. So he tells you, oh, by the way, before you leave, drop all my shit. Alright. Let's sit on the couch.
Alright. I'm gonna say a word. I want you to say the first thing that comes to mind. Dog.
Cat.
House.
Shelter.
Night.
Bandit. Shroud. Oh, I could pick other stuff. that's cool. Crush.
Light. Mother.
Human shield? Wow, human shield. All right, caretaker.
Okay, now I got a few statements. I want you to tell me how much they sound like something you'd say. First one, conflict just ain't in my nature.
No opinion.
I ain't given to relying on others for support.
I disagree, I obviously.
I'm always fixing to be the center of attention.
I'm a streamer, what do you mean?
I'm slow to embrace new ideas.
Nope.
I charge in to deal with my problems head on.
Hell yeah.
Almost done here. What do you say you have a look at this? Tell me what you see.
Broken chain, a chemical reaction, a shadow in a door frame. Oozing wound, angry two-headed ant. That's all I have to pick from. I don't know, honestly. Maybe a chemical reaction.
Okay. How about this one?
Priceless work of art, pieces of space age technology, ship at sea. Too embarrassed to say what it looks like. Yep, it's a penis. It's a penis.
Last one.
Totally against violence. Yeah, exactly. Light in the darkness. A bearded man. Is that a bearded man? That's crazy. Mushroom cloud. Head on a pillow. You know what? I'll go with bearded man.
Well, that's all she wrote. I don't have nothing to compare it to, so maybe you'd better just have a look at the results. See if it all seems right to you.
So I get a science boost, sneak boost, unarmed boost. We'll do a science boost. How much you can influence someone through dialogue and gain access to information they might otherwise not want to share. Use hit points, receive food and drink. Also helps you create consumable items at campfires. Easier to remain undetected. Steal an item or pick someone's pocket, successfully attacking while undetected grants an automatic critical hit. Hell yeah. We like that. And I want to definitely do guns, I believe. I mean, this is a game with guns in it. I don't think going melee is going to be a smart idea. I might be wrong, but I don't think it's going to be a smart idea.
Before I turn you loose, I need one more thing from you. You got a form for you to fill out so I can get a sense of your medical history. Just a formality. Ain't like I expect to find you got a family history of getting shot in the head.
It sounds like a Southern General Tullius. Condition decays, no. Probably because your mutants that live there. Game wants to do special tributes when outside, but suffer when indoors. Early riser, joy plus 2 to each of your special tributes from 6 a.m. to 12, but suffer minus 1 from 6 to 6. While wearing any type of glasses, you have 1 perception. Without glasses, you have negative 1. More prone to solving problems with your mind than violence. Gain 5 to barter, medicine, repair, science, speech, but have negative 5 to energy weapons, explosive guns, melee weapons, and unarmed. Your melee unarmed attacks do more damage, but less critical hit damage. Character can suffer -1 to all attributes anytime the weight you're carrying drops below 160. What the heck? Okay. I mean, Hoarder does sound like me. It does sound like me. I just stole all this guy's shit. Like, it sounds like it. It's 100% sounds like me. Your health drops below 50%, you gain 10% more damage, but you also suffer -2 to your agility and perception attributes. You have 10 action points, but your reckless nature causes you to have -2 damage threshold. We'll put you out of pasture because you're going to stay young and level 30 forever. Eric again become addicted to chems, but they'll last twice as long. After 30, you can kiss experience perks and skill points goodbye. No. Throw weapon 30% faster at the cost of 25% less range. Gain 5 points every skill, but you suffered -10% from experience gained from now on. I don't know about that. You have 1 agility, but your limbs are more easily crippled. You know what? I think trigger discipline might be good. Wait, can I do trigger discipline with, Yeah. If I do it with fast shot, I get faster fire rate, but less accurate. They just cancel each other out, never mind. Wild Wasteland unleashes the most bizarre and silly elements of the post-apocalyptic America, not for the faint of heart or the serious of temperament. Yeah, never mind. Guess we'll go hot-blooded. We'll do that.
Alright, I guess that about does it. Come with me, I'll see you out.
Yeah, I didn't take his hat. I forgot his hat.
Here, these are yours. Was all you had on you when you was brought in. I hope you don't mind, but I gave the note a look. I thought it might help me find a next of kin. But it was just something about a platinum chip. Well, if you're heading back out there, you ought to have this. They call it a Pip-Boy. I grew up in one of them vaults they made before the war. We all got one. Ain't much use to me now, but you might want such a thing after what you've been through. I know what it's like having something taken from you. And put this on, too, so the locals don't pick on you for lacking modesty. Never was much my style, anyway.
Thanks for patching me up, Doc.
Don't mention it. It's what I'm here for. You should talk to Sunny Smiles before you leave town. She can help you learn to fend for yourself in the desert. She'll likely be at the saloon. I reckon some of the other folks at the saloon might be able to help you out too. And the metal fella, Victor, who pulled you out of your grave. Anyway, you ever get hurt out there, you come right back. I'll fix you up. But try not to get killed anymore.
The metal feller. No, maybe I'll do hardcore later. I'm not doing hardcore my first playthrough, obviously. Ain't that a kick in the head? Sell stuff before I talk to Sunny? Okay. Found a fragment signal on Pip-Boy, a code of transmission of some sort with a sad, jazzy undercurrent. Makes your head hurt. As far as you can tell, it appears to be an invitation to the Midnight Science Fiction feature. Mojave driving. Please arrive early to catch the trailers. Old World Blues have been loaded. Your level cap has been raised by 5. Pip-Boy has received signal from coordinates that lead canyon wreckage west of Prim, following its coordinates to World. Courier 6 is signed Ulysses. Once the remote has been loaded, your level cap. Okay. I'm Happy Trails Caravan Company. Okay, so. Mojave Wasteland has kicked weapon manufacturing into high gear. All major and minor weapon dealers in the region are rolling in new weapons, ammo types, modifications. Head to your nearest participating vendor to pursue the merchandise. All gunrunner's arsenal has been unloaded. Okay. I have discovered good springs. And I am fat as flip. Radio broadcast inviting you to grand opening of Sierra Madre Casino. Hey, another level up. Okay, so that's block, that's attack. That's VATS, apparently. Vault Tech assisted targeting system or VATS. VATS displays chance of you will hit along with the condition of each body part. RT is attack, change body parts, change targets, cancel an attack, accept your actions. Third person. Okay, so at least crouch is the same. CND, I guess, is condition, question mark. Stim pack, doctor bag, don't need that right away. All weapons fall under the weapon skill category that determines how effective a weapon is. Guns, energy weapons, explosive melee weapons, or unarmed. Press small icon below to the left of the weapons icon, Pip-Boy skill menu. Damn DPS, indicate the base damage per second, strength, skill. Many weapons have strength or skill requirements. Strength or skill craft the weapons, aim will wobble if a firearm or will attack slowly. CND, weapons condition. At 75% or higher, does maximum damage only needs to be maintained. And it may jam. Laser pistol has a low condition. Mercenary grenade rifle. Hey, what's mod? Oh. So if I had mods, I can put it in there. Data. Okay. Okay. So because it's a shotgun, that's why I can't do that. I figured coming to the gas station to sell stuff would make sense, but there's only this vending machine. Can I put away this shotgun? Open vending machine. Check the outside. Up there is a truck in the driveway. Can I take the truck and drive it? Is it GTA? No. I can't GTA. Okay. That's a gas can? Oh boy. I wonder if that's explodable. Just not even like 10 minutes in and I just blow myself up on an old truck. Door to the gas station requires key. Okay. There's a general store close to the Doc's house. Okay. Yeah, like I said, I have no idea what the hell I'm doing, so. This is as Aladdin and Jasmine would say, a whole new world. I'm used to Skyrim having like the traders, and I know Skyrim very well now. Like, if I would love to be able to like erase everything about Skyrim in my head and start over from fresh in the Skyrim map. A map. a guy with a red mohawk slowly walking through town. It should be in data, okay. Well, that's a gas station. Dr. Mitchell's house. Okay. I was wondering if you could zoom in or not. I mean, obviously the saloon I'm thinking is over here. Yeah, oh, there's a general store right there. Alright. Onward! To our greatest! God, this is so slow. I had to steal everything from the dock, didn't I? I just had to steal everything. Oh, it's a crow. Can I shoot the crow? Damn. Hello, friend.
You must be the one Doc Mitchell was patching up. The way I heard it, I didn't think you'd be walking out of that office. I've got plenty of supplies for sale. Even got some weapon mods and special ammo. Well worth the caps, if you ask me. If you're hurting for caps, I've also got boxes of surplus ammo in the miscellaneous section. They're not great, but you get what you pay for. Can do.
Are bobby pins like lockpicks? Maybe I shouldn't do that yet. Okay, it is like that. Okay, cool. Ooh, dynamite. Gray? Is it like a color or? Or the GRA, the mods on it? Ooh, silenced pistol. Bonus crit damage and bonus crit chance. What's up, fire? Straight razor. Alright, I just really like the idea of a silenced pistol.
Thanks.
Only surplus ammo inferior.
It's all about quantity over quality. Trouble is, you'll be cleaning and fixing your gun a lot more than usual when you use those kind of bullets. Weapon mods are things like silencers, scopes, bigger magazines. Special ammo includes things like armor-piercing bullets, which don't hurt the target as much, but let you punch through armor easier. There's also hollow point bullets, which have the opposite effect. You can kill unarmored targets easier, but they don't do shit against armor.
You know anything about the people who attacked me?
The leader was a New Vegas type. Typical city boy. He had a bunch of Great Khans with him, probably hired guns. The Great Khans normally stay in their own territory way up northwest, on account of them being enemies with the NCR.
Have you ever been to New Vegas?
Twice. Both times I drank a lot of liquor and lost most of my caps at the card tables. In that order, now that I think about it. If you ever get to New Vegas, be sure to visit Gamora. It's the best casino in the city. You won't regret it. Word of advice, behave. Between the NCR military police and Mr. House's robots, you don't want to be causing trouble on the strip.
You know, I'd like to know more about Mr. House.
I'm afraid I don't know much myself. Mr. House has got his own casino, Lucky 38, but nobody goes in or out except his robots. The other casinos follow Mr. House's rules, so I guess that makes him the leader of New Vegas. As far as I know, nobody's ever laid eyes on the guy. I think that robot who pulled you out of the dirt belongs to Mr. House. If Mr. House is looking after you, it's got to be a good thing, right?
Anything else you could tell me about the Great Khans?
They're tough sons of bitches. Mean, but not crazy. They'll leave you alone unless you got something they want. The Great Khans deal in illegal chems. There's a good chance that most chems you come across were made by Great Khans.
Goodbye.
Take it easy now.
That's why I just casually shoot him in the face. Let's not commit crimes. I don't see any guards, but I don't want to piss anybody off. All these motorcycles and shit, and I can't take any of them. Hi, Easy Pete.
Howdy. What can Easy Pete do for you?
Do you know anything about the people who attacked me?
The one in the fancy suit seemed to be calling the shots. That's as much as I know. Other folks in town might know more. Word of advice, though. If you ever catch up with him, watch out. The man's got cold eyes like a snake. Can't be trusted, I'd say.
Why are you called Easy Pete?
Was a prospector until I decided to settle here to get away from the NCR. Now, we'll just take it easy and help out with the Brahmin and Bighorners.
You were a prospector, like digging for gold and silver?
Nah. Means I poked through old buildings looking for working tech and such. Some folks just call it salvaging, but never liked the term. Way I see it, salvage means it's broken, near worthless. Me, I look for the good stuff. Guns, chems, spare parts. Good money in it.
You ever find any good while prospecting?
Nope. Had a pretty good claim once, way out east by the river, but got run off by raiders. Eventually got too old to keep going out.
Dragon's Dogma? No, I haven't. I haven't done much outside of like Final Fantasy series, Skyrim, and a couple other like RPGs. What's wrong with the NCR?
Don't get me wrong. The NCR's got a lot of decent folk in it. It's just that they make you part of them whether you like it or not. Towns like Good Springs and Prim don't stay independent for long. Not if you've got something the NCR wants. Still, the NCR keeps the Legion away.
Tell me about the Legion.
They're slavers, led by a guy named Caesar, or Kaisar. Not sure how you're supposed to say it. A couple of years ago, they tried to take over Hoover Dam, but the NCR beat them back. The NCR didn't or couldn't finish the job, though. The Legion's got its strength back and is getting ready for another round at the dam. My money's still on the NCR winning, but you never know. We've been hearing stories about legionaries on the Nevada side of the river, so keep a gun handy. You don't want to get caught by them.
What's up about the Hoover Dam, besides obvious resources?
The dam powers a lot of New Vegas, and then there's all that clean water lying in Lake Mead, too. Anybody who owns the dam owns the territory.
What do you use Brighthorners for? Bighorners for?
Meat and hide, mostly. Can't put a pack on them. They just lay down until you take it off. Can find a bunch of wild ones high up in the hills, but gotta be careful around them. They can put up a decent fight if cornered.
You know anything about Victor?
The machine? Harmless, no matter what Trudy says. She thinks it's hiding something. But I think it's just a broken-down relic with no place to be.
Goodbye.
Keep your gun handy if you go poking around some of the abandoned places around here, like the schoolhouse. Critters move in there sometimes.
Oh, God. I forgot rat roaches. Like I said, I have played Fallout Shelter, the mobile game. So, oh my God, it's so nice to be able to jump. Oh! I can jump around. Is there like a sprint button? No. Not me wasting all my fucking ammo. So I guess I'm just stuck going at this speed. He's just in by the old schoolhouse, so hey, you know what? Let's go to the old schoolhouse. Why not? I'm guessing this is it because of the bell tower. Oh, look at that! Oh, look at that. Oh, fuck off. What? How? Die. Ooh. Kill shot. Fucking hell. Tin can. Nuka-Cola truck. Hammer. Some four legs. Programmer's Digest. Safe. Need a lockpick skill of 25. Some terminals are protected and can't be accessed without a password. If your science skill is high enough, you can attempt to hack the terminal. Select the correct password to grant you access. If you guess it is incorrect, you'll be shown how many letters match the correct password in the correct location. Four tries to guess correctly. Oh, this is Wordle. This is a four-letter Wordle. Awesome. I mean, it's next one until you own the password. You can exit hacking at any time. So is it a word? Like, it could be anything that I pick out of here? Wait, that was it? That was it. Holy shit. I really just guessed the password in the first shot. Wow. Mind you, I can't be more transparent. I did not look that up. I did not look that up at all. Holy shit. Mentads. Sneak plus 100. Stealth field plus 75. What the hell? I don't know, like, I was gonna do everything, but it looked like tactical or whatever. It just felt like it was the better option than the schoolhouse. Mantis Othica. Locker. That's the door to leave. All those lockers are empty. Oh, okay. So all these desks are lootable, question mark. Man, there's that. Are these tables? No, they're just solid tables. I feel like every time I hit a board, it's like hitting a bone or something in Skyrim. I'm just gonna take damage, like, randomly. Something in here. Ashtray and a tin can. Okay. Well, wait, what's in here? Toy cars. Hell yeah. Baseball glove and Nuka-Cola truck. Baseball glove. No glove, no love. Can't steal the brooms. Cherry bomb. Box of detergent. Ashtray. Braxa cleaner. You think I'll be able to take the pipettes? Some more bobby pins. I'll take those bobby pins too. Okay, cool. Can I steal the clock? No, I can't steal the clock. Anything else? I think I've pretty much looted this place. I'm impressed that I got that on the first try. Holy crap. Alright, well, cool. That is schoolhouse done. You're off to start your own playthrough? Nice, Raj. Obviously, you're going to be centuries ahead of me. So, I have no fucking clue what the hell I'm doing. Is that a flashlight? That's a flashlight. Why can't I pick it up? I mean, it kind of looks like a flashlight. Maybe it's not. I'm so used to hitting that button, like the third person button for sprinting. Because of Skyrim. So now I'm just doing that over and over. Okay. Somebody owns this property. I turn off their power. You didn't pay your bill, Mr. Robinson. Oh, that's Doc Mitchell's house. I'm back at the doc's house. I'm about to steal the doctor's porn. Like I wasn't ingrate, like a big enough ingrate as it was. Hey, thanks for patching me up, Doc. I'm gonna steal all your food. No. Alright, so I can't break the wooden pieces off the doors. So I guess that house is just unlootable. Can't break crates with guns. There's nobody home. But this, we'll keep our good karma for now. If it's an empty house, then I'll steal from it. Otherwise, I don't think I want to steal from it. Hello, bully. Are you domesticated? Are you good? Are you gonna attack me if I get close? Hi, bud. Aren't you a piece of work? Hi. Your eyes move. Hey, friend. Can I ride you? Can we go on an adventure together, you and me? Let me just get on your back. Ugh. Ugh. No? Okay. He likes me. He likes me. Another empty bottle. Hello, big robot.
Howdy, partner.
Oh, God.
Might I say you're looking fit as a fiddle?
Oh, this is gonna get annoying quick. Thanks for digging me out of that grave, mister.
Don't mention it. I'm always ready to lend a helping hand to a stranger in need.
How'd you happen to find me?
I was out for a stroll that night when I heard the commotion up the old bone orchard. Saw what looked like a bunch of bad eggs, so I laid low. Once they had run off, I dug you up to see if you were still kicking. Turns out you were. So I hauled you off to the dock right quick.
Do you know who those men were who attacked me?
Can't say that I'm familiar with the rascals. Some of the fine folks in town might be able to help you out with that.
How did you end up in Good Springs?
I moseyed into town, 10, 15 years ago. Before that, I can't quite seem to recall. odd. Anyway, it's a right peaceful town, and I reckon it's as fine a place to settle as any.
I never seen a robot like you before.
I'm a Securitron. Robco Security Model 2060B. If you ever see any of my brothers, tell them Victor says howdy. Happy trails! Howdy, partner.
I just wanted to hear it.
Happy trails!
Howdy,
partner.
Happy trails! I just like hearing the howdy, partner. Open. I'm gonna go inside your shack. Oh. You don't mind if I take your stuff? Okay. Well, my robotic friend, if you don't mind me taking advantage of your kindness, I will do exactly that. We got a weapon repair kit. All right. I like free stuff. It feels so good in my inventory. Yeehaw!
Howdy, partner.
Howdy, partner. You've been using a cowboy as cat for some time? Oh, boy. I bet you look like a sexy young man. Yes, sir. I bet you can woo all kinds of ladies out there with that big old hat of yours. Let's see. Nope. His own house. Alright, if it's owned, who is here? You know what I like? I like Fable. Okay, I like the idea of Fable. That if you kill someone, you can take ownership of... You take ownership of their house, and then, you know, basically make the property yours, because, I mean, the owner's dead. I always thought that was a pretty fun... interesting approach with Fable. You just start killing off business people and everything else, and all of a sudden, hey, you're the new owner of the business, or the new owner of the house, you know. Somebody left the cherry bomb in there, and that is not okay. Plunger, scrap metal, wonder glue, wrench. Sir, I'm here to talk to you about our Lord and Savior, Victor. His famous words are, howdy, partner. It's the way that we shall live our lives. Every time we meet someone, say, howdy, partner. That's going to be the whole playthrough, is me saying, howdy, partner. The start of every stream is going to be, howdy, partner. And you'll know what day it is. If you hear me say howdy, partner, then you know what we're doing today. Got a BB gun. Carton of cigarettes. Merc grunt outfit. Interesting. Howdy, partner. That's so dumb. I should not be having that much fun with just what a robot said. I mean, if I can use as many beds and stools, I mean, it makes me question what house should be mine. Like, is this house free and clear to use now, or can I just, like, move in there and be like, hey, cool. Hey, guys. How's it going? Can I ride you? You have a big brother over there that he didn't want me to ride him either, but can I get on you? Will you let me on you? I'm trying not to accidentally hit the shotgun button so I don't shoot them in the head. I feel like that'd be a really dick thing to do. Hey, friend.
That Doc Mitchell sure knows the stuff, doesn't he? Hey there. That Doc Mitchell. Howdy.
Alright. I did the whole Skyrim guard thing where I just spammed the button and see what was gonna get said. I'm gonna check every property here. I think I got this side of town licked. Minus this little property here. Howdy, partner! That's what I should do. I should record that and take that audio section. Every time somebody subscribes to the channel from now on, they just get a howdy partner. I kind of like that idea. I might do that. The reloading bench. Interesting. SEC to MFC. Miss Little Rocket. Gas bomb. Okay. So I'm selling all this shit that I have no idea that I could be using. Of course. So this is trying to turn out to be like 7 Days to Die meets Skyrim. Only problem is on this game, I don't have I'm trying not to go to the saloon yet. I'm doing everything but the saloon because I want to check everything else out. I figured the saloon was going to progress main storyline quest, so that's why we're doing that last. Look at that handsome man right here. Hey, you're young? You're so big, though. You're so big. How are you young? Hi. Aw, you being shy, buddy? You being shy? Look at you. You're just a handsome man. Yeah, I hope it's a man. Be really sexy if that wasn't a man. That's not a male. I am sorry for being sexist. Okay, I'm sorry.
Way too many strangers coming into town these days. No offense.
Hey there.
Howdy. That Doc Mitchell sure knows. Way too many strangers coming into town these days.
Okay.
No offense.
Let's see if you have anything I can borrow. Yeah, you do. But it's gonna be considered pilfering. Mole fruit, grilled mantis. Yeah, again, let's keep our karma up pretty high. I don't want to start stealing everything. Maybe later, if I start hurting for caps, I'll consider starting to steal, but right now, we're not exactly hurting for caps, so... Hello, handsome. He is indeed a male? Okay, good. Oof. I don't want... Oh, hi. Nice. I don't want feminists jumping on me because I assume gender. Like, God forbid. Boxing time. Slowly clearing out place by place here. Is there a back door here? It's a maze, a maze. Meeting people. Sensor module. I can sleep in here too. Empty whiskey bottle. Sunspit spasperbilla. Cause I can't talk. We don't know how to talk in these here parts. Another BB gun. Okay. Can't enter that house. What are you? You're a shit bucket. I wonder if they still have toilets. I mean, they have toilets, but I wonder if they're usable. That place is locked up tighter than Fort Knox. I think that's the last house I was had to look at. There is an uphill right there. Let's see what's up here. Then we'll check the water tower, and then I guess the saloon. Keep out. Stop. Alright. I'll keep out. I will trust the game and its environment that it would not lead me astray or make me go anywhere that I shouldn't go. Is this water tower where I was put into? My shallow grave, so to say. Steppy step. I feel like I should be able to allow to run. If I can run, I don't know how to run. Good spring cemetery. Whoop. Oh. That looked promising. Excuse me. Empty bottles. Hell yeah. Ooh. Tin camp or tin man. Are these respawning behind me or am I just blind? Maybe a bit of both. A lot of keep out signs. Oh. Alright, well, I guess we head back town. That's Snow Glove. they do, I'd pull out a form of card, see the mutant of a goat, apparently. Make him effectively a ram. He's like a ram slash cow, I guess. I don't know. Some weird hybrid. That are just a really, really beefy ram. I'm gonna grab this snow globe. Might be important. Or not. Limited edition Mojave Landmark Snow Globe. These rare pre-war artifacts are widely considered to be useless baubles, but rumor has it, some collectors will pay dearly for them. Okay, so I found a collectible. Alright, that's cool. I thought it was just a random piece of junk or quest item, but... Okay. I am over-encumbered. I feel like I'm going to have that a lot. Alright, let's try to make our way back to the general goods store. Slow and steady. Excuse me? It sounded like I just kicked a can, but there's no can near me. Whatever the hell that sound is, I don't want to go there. Hey, there's a giant church? Question mark? Religious landmark? Some more buildings that way. What's that way? Okay, well, there's a lot to explore, that's for sure. This isn't like Skyrim, where it's like Riverwood and then like 1,000 yards away, like, you know, a whole town or something. I feel like that's the one thing that's bad about Skyrim is that there's not enough towns. There are not enough interesting places. Like, there's a lot of, like, don't get me wrong, a lot of, like, main towns. You think about, like, Rorikstead, you have Iverstead, you know, and all that stuff. And don't get me wrong, that's cool, but you can go through the main storyline quest without ever touching any of those towns except for maybe Iverstead. On a first time casual playthrough, you'd pass through there. But I mean, there's a lot of places that even after 10 years, I still haven't. I didn't recognize they were places. Like, there's an independent mine out by Morthal, and I didn't know about it until very recently. I've explored Skyrim's map, but it's just, if there's no quest that leads you out there, and the only way you're going to get a quest is if you go there and help the quest that's there, then it's like, you never know. They sell for 1,000 caps. Well, that sounds pretty good. I don't know, maybe I'll keep it for sentimental value. Oh my goodness. Riveting gameplay, I'm sure. Riveting gameplay. Just me fat waddling my ass all the way back over here. Well, yeah. Although it is said that Skyrim is... There's been theories that Skyrim is held after the Fallout series. But I highly doubt that's true. There are people saying that, like, oh yeah, Skyrim takes place after Fallout. It's like, how? One, there's dragons. Well, not many dragons, obviously, because, I mean, for Dragonborn, we start killing them. But, one, there's dragons there. Two, it's just totally different, right? I mean, even post-apocalyptic right here, we still have technology. So, seems kind of weird.
Howdy. You looking to buy some supplies? Can do.
bum 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 bum. Like, part of me wants to take this stuff, and instead of sell it, I just want to, like, store it somewhere. Because maybe I could use it later. And it's making me really iffy about it, you know what I mean? Like...
Take it easy.
I thought I was going to shoot him for a second. I was like, wait a second. Maybe I should go to the outside workbenches first. Let's make our way to the workbenches. See what we can make first, and then sell whatever's left over. I always get dumb phone calls from, like, random companies. I'll make 9 of each. I don't know what they do, but you know what? I'll make them. Hair weight do I have? I have only 200. I'm at 218 right now. I should have taken that perk that says anything over 160, I get a bonus. That would have been smart, honestly.
Howdy. You looking to buy some supplies? Can do.
Fission batteries. Do I sell them? They're valued at 150, and I'm only getting paid 39 for them. But it's gonna drop 12 weight off me. Maybe I'll keep one and sell the other. That doesn't weigh anything, so I'll also keep it. Pilot light. Plunger. Do more money. Scrap electronics. I know I need to keep the scrap. See, the weight is the problem. Like, when it weighs like 4 or something, like, I feel like that's like nickel and diming me so much. Like, I know Wonder Glue is useful. I know wrenches are useful. Turpentine, I don't know, man. Gun CND damage, target DT. I'm getting so screwed. I'm literally getting like half the value for most things, if not like a minor fraction.
Right. Another satisfied customer.
Yeah.
Take it easy now.
Alright. I can move now freely. I'm at 127 to 200. Alright. Let us go and go talk to Sunrise Sally, whatever the hell her name is.
Cheyenne, stay. Don't worry, she won't bite unless I tell her to.
Doc Mitchell said you could teach me to survive in the desert.
Yeah, I guess there's a thing or two I could show you. Sounds like you need all the help you can get after what they done to you. Meet me outside, behind the saloon.
Oh. Wait, where'd the puppy go?
Now, see the sarsaparilla bottles on the fence there? Take this and try to hit a couple of them.
Shit. Yeah, look. I'm using a fucked up controller. Give me a break. Come on. Get back the other way a little bit. No. Fuck. Dude, what is with my controller? Ah! Okay, there we go. Nope. Can't shoot that one. Can I just get, like, something? Okay, you know what? How about this? I just get really up close and personal.
That's the right idea. Look down the sight.
To aim. LT. Oh my fucking god. No, I can do that. Oh, okay. Oh, anytime you move over, it changes your. Oh, what the fuck? Fuck game. Okay, that was straight down the frickin' sight. I don't know what you're talking about. I don't understand guns.
You're crouching down and staying still. It'll help your aim.
Oh, now you want me to crouch down, okay.
Nice shot. Well, that's a start. But I don't reckon you came to me to learn to fight sarsaparilla bottles. Tell you what, I gotta go chase geckos away from our water supply anyway. Darn critters are attracted to it. Why don't you come along?
I'm in.
Follow me. It's just down to the southeast a short ways.
Hello, Cheyenne. I like the puppies. The puppies is the cool part about this game right now. Took me an hour and a half to get to the tutorial. You know what? Fuck, I don't care. I'm enjoying this. I'm enjoying this. So. Are we there yet? That sounds promising.
Hear that up on the ridge behind me there? We got some geckos to clear out. Bunch of little monsters is what they are. Seems like Doc Mitchell treats more gecko bites than anything else. Let's see if we can get a little closer. If we move quietly, we can get the jump on them. More likely to hit something vital that way. Okay, you're on. Go give them hell.
I crippled its head before I killed it. Alright, well that's cool. Activate water valve. I didn't take any damage. Not bad.
Getting the hang of it. There's two more wells that still need clearing.
Oh.
If you want, you can come along. It'd be...
Sure, I'll come with you.
Shouldn't take more than a couple minutes, especially with two of us. Come with me.
Come with me if you want your caps. I'm saying, she's low res, but damn, she got booty. I gotta loot. Hey Cheyenne. Shy Shy. Call her Shy Shy. Damn it. She done ran out. Oh goodness gracious. Where the hell is she? Oh wait, on my HUD. Keep forgetting about the whole HUD thing. I'm so used to Skyrim's HUD being like above my head. hell are you?
Howdy. Holy moly. If you hadn't come here like you done, I'd be a goner for sure. I came up here to draw water, but here, you should have.
Yeah, unfortunately, it's my first playthrough, so I'm not gonna turn off HUD. You've established a reputation with a group of people in the wasteland, whether that reputation is good or bad, you're finally somebody. And people associated with that group will start to react to you with what you've done. Many different factions in the wasteland, you can develop a distinct reputation with each one. As you perform actions that benefit the group, you'll gain fame. From actions that harm a group, you will gain infamy. Your reputation with any given group is a measure of the combined total of fame and infamy that you have earned. The benefits and drawbacks of any given reputation depend on the group itself. You may receive discounts with merchants, provoke attacks from hired thugs, or simply be treated differently.
Now that was some good work. Even got a little exciting there at the end. Here's a little spending money for the trouble. One more thing I wanted to show you. Thought I might teach you about living off the land. And making useful things for yourself. Interested?
Couldn't hurt.
All right, then. We'll need a couple ingredients to get started. Gonna want some Xander root and a Brock flower. Let me think now. I know I've seen Brock flowers growing up at the graveyard, and I seem to remember there being Xander root over by the schoolhouse. Bring those on back to me, and we'll get cooking. Everything all right? Well, let's just finish this first, all right? Then we could talk. Preferably somewhere where I can get a stiff drink and Cheyenne can keep cool.
Okay, if you say so. Ooh, D-box, open toolbox, the radio. Got the radio playing. Oh, it's data? Yeah, data. Okay, there we go. No thank you. I'm not gonna skip the tutorial. I appreciate the recommendation, though. Holy fucking hell! Now! No shit, weapons in poor condition. Come on, anytime now! What the hell? Is this a permanent effect? Or is it temporary? If I read the meeting people, is that permanent effect? Game gets a lot better after the tutorial. That's not permanent. Don't take buff out unless you're trying to win a fight. Okay. Weapon spread reduced. Back effect. Repairs current weapons. Okay. Hey! That's some health. Woo! Damn it. Here we go. Some books in front of it, but not the magazines. Okay. I'll keep that in mind. I don't think I'm gonna find any books probably right off the bat like this, though. Damn it. Damn it. No, I'm blaming the gun. It's definitely the gun. Yeah, there we go. See, it's the gun. Totally the gun. What was I coming up here for? I forgot. There's something that grows near the cemetery here. Oh, rock flowers. And there's like a Xander seed or whatever the flip by the school. Is that the only one? Yeah, I guess it's only the one. That scorpion, this guy came out of nowhere. Might have to be careful about fast traveling, especially at night. Alright, let's head over to the schoolhouse. No, that's the doc's house. Sir, are you okay? Are you having a midlife crisis?
Hey there. If you're looking for supplies, Chet over at the general store can help you out.
I think he's having a crisis. He lost his keys. Oh, tumbleweed. I thought this was just stationary. Oh, that's so cool. Going from Skyrim to this, where there's interactable objects like this, is kind of fun. It's just tumbleweed, but God, I'm so impressed by it. It's so dumb, but it's so weird. Anyways, I gotta find this Xander root or the heck. I don't know what I'm looking for, so that's the worst part. Hi. How about you stop? How about you stop all of that? Alright. This, whatever the hell it is supposed to be here. Oh, wait. Is that it? That's jalapeno. Found jalapenos. Coyote tobacco. Well, it's definitely not a Skyrim. There ain't plants everywhere, that's for sure. Where the hell is you? Sit over by the schoolyard. My Brockflower and a Xander root. Wait, am I being dumb? Is the Xander root like marked on the map? Pass by it. Oh. Wow. Because that's not easy to fucking miss. Okay. Bring it to Sunny at the campfire, who is apparently over here. I gotta get used to the HUD being down there, like the little map. I'm so used to the map being like in my face up top. I'm not used to it being on the bottom like this. Why is Sunny making me come all the way out here? Sunny, we need to talk about your ideal choices of where everything is. This game makes you search sometimes better. When I come back to a quest, just like in real life. Nope. I refuse. I am a hard-headed, stubborn son of a gun, and I will make sure that I get these quests done ASAP. What the hell? Over here. What am I looking at here? Just fill up on water. Hi. Such a litter bug. Oh my gosh. Because the bomb went off and everyone's like, you know, gotta be weird. Doesn't mean that we have to be all freaking messy. Guys, come on. Protect the environment.
Let me see what you got. Yeah, these'll do just fine. Just fine. All right now. We're going to be making something folks on the trail call healing powder. Go on over to that campfire now. Give it a try.
Oh.
Hey, that's not bad, see? All it takes to make a recipe is the right ingredients and the right know-how. Sometimes it won't be a campfire you need. Might need to do some work on your guns and ammo, maybe. Important thing to get is it's all the same idea. You just need to find the right place to set up shop. Workbench or reloading bench, whatever. Well, I hope that's enough to get you started. I'm heading back now. Hope I didn't miss anything good on the jukebox. Cheyenne would never forgive me. Hey, do me a favor. Trudy, she's the bartender up at the Prospector. Kind of the town mom. She likes to meet newcomers. She'd be cross with me if I didn't ask you to poke your head in and say hi. Hi there. Sticking around Good Springs for...
And you get to Prim, can you suggest a route?
Sure can. Take the road southeast out of town till it hits the freeway. Prim is the town with the roller coaster straight south. Can't miss it. NCR patrols do a good job of keeping the highway clear. But I'd keep your gun where you can reach it easily. You never know who you'll run into. Off the road, you'll probably start running into hostile wildlife. My advice would be to stick to the highway when you can.
What do you do around here?
I hunt geckos mostly. The meat's pretty good, and I can always find a buyer for the hides. I also help keep the town clear of rad scorpions and coyotes. Not many people live in Good Springs, so wildlife is always creeping in.
Let's talk about the areas around Good Springs.
Sure. What do you want to know?
What other towns are nearby?
Southeast of here is Prim. Can't miss it. Since it has the giant old roller coaster right in the middle of town. The NCR's got an outpost there. If you follow the road north, you'll eventually hit Sloan and Quarry Junction. They mine rocks or something, but I heard they got troubles lately. I wouldn't head that direction if I were you, though. Got critters up there that don't take kindly to getting shot.
NCR?
The New California Republic. Bunch of settlers and soldiers coming in from the west, fixing on making Nevada their own. They can be right pushy, but the roads are safer because of them, so I tend to let it go. Not that I got a choice.
What does NCR keep you safe from?
Well, the wildlife for one thing, rowdy locals for another. They're protecting their own. Just happens to help us. They've been holding off this other group from the east, too.
You know about the other group?
Got a funny name. Call themselves Caesar's Legion. Never seen them in these parts, so I couldn't tell you much. I hear rumors, that's about it. Supposedly, they keep slaves and they got some real nasty ways of killing folks. But maybe that's just something folks in the NCR cooked up to make themselves seem more useful here. Less uninvited.
What kind of creatures are out there?
Around here, mostly coyotes and geckos. The coyotes are pretty dangerous in large packs, but otherwise they're nothing to really worry about. The geckos aren't too tough, but they've got a nasty bite. I've heard about bigger, nastier versions out in the wasteland, but I've never seen them. Stick to the roads when you can, and steer clear of the hills north of Good Springs. The critters up there are big and poisonous. If you want to know anything else, just ask.
A little short on caps. I don't suppose there's any work available.
Not in Good Springs, no. But if you're up for a little scavenging, there's always the schoolhouse. Most of what's in there is junk, but there's this old safe that even Easy Pete wasn't able to crack with dynamite. If you want to take a shot at it, take these.
Magazine on locksmiths?
If the lock's too much for you to handle, reading through the magazine might give you the edge you need.
And the bobby pins?
You'll need those to pick the lock. Be careful, though. Put too much pressure on them, and they'll snap.
Actually, I already cracked that safe.
Oh. Well, go ahead and keep the stuff I gave you anyway. It'll be more useful to you than me.
Goodbye.
Until next time.
Puppies! 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 Hello, puppies. Alright, cool. Let's see. Guess I'm going this way. What is over here? Ah! What is here? What is... Vision Midnight showing at the Mojave Drive-In, Traveler Canyon Grim, by Heavy Trails Caravan Master, Sources here, Mutation, Prospector Saloon. Okay. That's Prim. That's Sloan. Okay. Abandoned BOS bunker. Wow. My frickin' childhood lisp is coming back. I don't know how I feel about that. It's not a big map, but at the same time, it is a pretty big map. I said not to go to Sloan, because they're having trouble, but to go south instead of Prim. Huh.
done being nice. If you don't hand Ringo over soon, I'm going to get my friends and we're burning this town to the ground. Got it?
We'll keep that in mind. Now, if you're not going to buy something, get out.
What the hell is your problem? What do you want?
What did you say about Ringo?
He's some traitor who decided he'd rather shoot than pay the toll for being in our territory. He's hiding somewhere in town. Would serve these idiots right if me and my guys shot the place up after we got payback on Ringo.
Is this area your territory?
It is now. Me and the rest of the guys busted out of the NCR prison east of here and took over. Now we're calling the shots.
What were you in prison for?
None of your damn business. You ought to know better than to ask a man that kind of question.
Never mind.
Yeah, forget about it.
Forget about it. What's been going on in the rest of the Wasteland?
Same old shit that's been going on for years. The NCR and Legion are still fighting over Hoover Dam for some reason.
We know about the Legion.
I've run with some tough gangs, but I gotta admit, they all got nothing on the Legion. I hear they stick you up on poles and it takes a while to die. I ain't saying I'm afraid of them or nothing, but I'll be staying out of their way.
Pussy. Tell me about the NCR.
New California Republic. Nothing new about it. Just a bunch of people with money and power pushing everyone else around. They've got troops all over the Mojave, but it's a big desert, so it's pretty easy to avoid them if you want.
You know anything about Hoover Dam?
Never been there since the NCR's got troops all over it. Must be pretty important.
Let's say I help you take over this town.
Let me get out of town before we talk. Too many unfriendly ears around. Yeah.
If you're looking for supplies, Chet over at the general store can help you out.
Howdy.
Well, you've been causing quite a stir. Glad I finally got to meet you. Welcome to the Prospector Saloon.
I overheard your argument. What was that all about?
Looks like our little town got itself dragged into the middle of something we don't want anything to do with. About a week ago, this traitor, Ringo, comes into town. Survivor of an attack, he says. Bad men after him. Needs a place to hide. We figured he was just in shock, so we gave him a place to lie low. We didn't actually expect anyone to come after him.
Where's Ringo now?
He's holed up at the abandoned gas station up the hill.
What are you going to do?
Some of the others, like Sonny, will probably stand up for Ringo if he asks for help, which he hasn't. Personally, I hope he sneaks out of town one night and takes the Powder Gangers with him.
Powder Gangers?
Chain gangs, really. The NCR brought them in from California to work on the rail lines. Problem is, it turns out that giving convicts a bunch of dynamite and blasting powder isn't the best idea. It was a big escape not too long ago. Some of them stuck together so they could make trouble. That's what we're dealing with now.
Why not just kill Cobb and be done with it?
You mean murder him? That's not our way, even if Cobb is scum. He can bluster and threaten all he wants. All right.
What happens if I help Ringo?
If you were able to get Ringo out of this mess, you'd have a decent reputation around Good Springs. I'd even set you up with a discount. Of course, helping Ringo would also make the Powder Gangers mad, and they've got a lot of friends out there.
Helping the Good Springs would like me more. What if I help the Powder Gangers?
Don't know why you'd want to do a thing like that. Yep, you'd get on their good side, but people around here wouldn't appreciate it one bit.
Who was the man you were arguing with?
He's a convict. Just without the chains. Said his name was Cobb. Powder Gangers is what they call themselves. Plenty more like him out there.
I heard that enough people who attacked me know anything about them?
Not much, other than they're a bunch of freeloaders who expected a few rounds on the house. I was able to get them to pay up, though. Of course, one of the great cons did knock my radio to the floor, by accident, and it hasn't been working since.
Did my attacker say where they were going?
They were having some kind of argument about it, but the guy in the checkered coat kept shushing them. Sounded like they came in from the north through Quarry Junction. If that's the case, I can't say I blame them for not wanting to go back.
Why is that?
That whole area is overrun with the kind of critters that just get mad if you shoot them. Merchants avoid that whole stretch of I-15 like it's radioactive, which it could be for all I know.
So where are they heading?
I didn't hear exactly, but the leader was talking about the strip. Fellow wants to get there and avoid the 15, he'd have to go east. Take Highway 93 up.
Let me take a look at your broken radio?
Sure, the outside looks okay, but I think something broke on the inside. There'd be caps in it for you. I do like to hear what's going on in the world. And that Mr. New Vegas seems like such a gentleman.
Do you know about the robot that rescued me?
I know that thing as much as anyone else around here. It mostly keeps to itself, which is just fine by me.
You don't like him?
It acts friendly enough, but I don't trust that whole cheerful cowboy act. I find it all very creepy.
Mm-hmm. What does he actually do around here?
Other than rolling around once in a while, it doesn't do anything useful as far as I can tell. I don't know why it took an interest in you, but I'd be careful. It's never helped anyone before.
How long has he been in Good Springs?
It was here when I took over the saloon 7 years ago. Some people have said its owner lived here, but no one knows who it was. Fine by me.
Does Good Springs get many visitors?
Mostly traders looking to buy bighorn or meat and hides. The traders are the main reason the general store manages to stay in business. Most travelers heading south on the I-15 just push on towards Prim, unless they're in desperate need of supplies.
Anything interesting going on in the rest of the wasteland?
There's always something interesting going on, but the biggest news has to be the coming dust-up between the NCR and the Legion over the dam.
Tell me about the NCR.
The New California Republic's got the most power in Nevada. Money, troops, you name it. They do what they can to keep things safe in the region. But if you ask me, they're trying to do too much. They're spread too thin.
I think the NCR and the Legion both want the dam.
The Legion are a bunch of savages, though.
Whoops.
No idea why they'd want the dam. Probably plan on destroying it or something. I'm pretty sure the NCR wants to hold on to the dam because it's one of the few places around that can make electricity. The Legion are a bunch of savages, though.
Okay. What can you tell me about the Legion?
Slavers, killers, and all other kinds of trouble. They dress up like Roman soldiers, so there's no mistaking it when you see them. The rumor is that the Legion is far larger than the NCR lets on, and that it's been due to luck that the Legion hasn't overrun the territory.
What you got for sale?
Got a special discount for you, after what you done for us.
Reminds me of, this music sound, reminds me of, Oh Brother Where Art Thou, the movie. I don't know why, it just does. Alright.
Be careful out there.
Repair the radio.
Feeling thirsty?
I fixed your radio.
Yeah, I heard it turn right back on after you got done tinkering with it. Here's some caps for the work. You're welcome. So can I get you anything? Be careful out there.
Yeah, we level up. Woo! 14 points. Holy shit. Okay, let's put speech. I'm sure you're happy with another. I don't know, do you think speech of 30? Speech 25. School secretary 25. Okay. I'll take that advice. go barter. I'll put an extra point into guns. Oh, I can get a new one. Okay. You do 10%. Also, come at you. Some of that acts as a unique dialogue option when dealing with the same sex. You can put a single point into any of your special attributes. So, come at you. Some acts as a unique dialogue option when dealing with opposite sex. Perk perky additional 10% in total experience whenever experience points are earned. I mean, if I can learn, if I can gain experience quicker, that's good, right? Floor safe. Alright. So if I. If I help Ringo, the town's gonna like me more. If I help the Powder Gangers, the town's gonna hate me more. So I'll break even with the town, but I'll have better experience with the Powder Gangers. Survival says to make the Powder Gangers happy, but what's right says I help Ringo, and I don't like that idea too much, really, but whatever. Alright, let's go see Ringo at the gas station. Maybe next time I level up, I put points into strength so I can get more carry capacity. Yeah, it's just like Skyrim, carry weight's a pain in the ass in this game, it seems. Especially because I'm a hoarder.
That's close enough. Who are you, and what do you want with me?
I'm not an enemy if that's what you're asking.
Sorry about the gun. You just caught me off guard, that's all. We got off to a bad start. What say we start over with a friendly game of Caravan? You know how to play?
No, there's a man named Joe Cobb looking for you.
Yeah. He doesn't look very tough, though. I hear he's afraid I'll shoot him down from one of the windows when I see him. And he's right. I'll have a much bigger problem once his friends show up. There's no way I could handle all of them in a gunfight.
What can you do with the Powder Gangers?
I'm gonna lay low for as long as I can, assuming the town doesn't throw me to the wolves. I've got no chance against the gang on my own.
Maybe I can help.
We'd just end up sharing the same grave if it's just the two of us. Now, if some of the other people in town were also on board.
I'll ask around, see what I can round up.
Start with Sunny Smiles. She's been friendlier than most around here.
Yes, she has. I can confirm. Look, man, you gonna stay in here, you gotta clean up after yourself. This is ridiculous. Look, I'm not stealing. I am cleaning up the wasteland one building at a time. That's my story, and I'm sticking to it. Oh, but that's stealing. Okay. I need a lockpick of 25 or higher. Alright, well. Now that I'm officially fat again. Hey! Vision battery. I may not be able to jump, but I can walk on this. I can get the extra inch I need. Yeah, next level up, I'm definitely putting points into strength. Screw this. Ridiculous. Having only 200 is... it sucks. I should have taken the carrying capacity perk. I should have. Drop stuff? Hell no! I'm close to the general store. I'll sell it. I'll sell before I do anything else. See if I can craft things too. I wonder if, do I get experience by crafting? I didn't check whenever I made that stuff earlier. I should definitely check it out this time. Keep an eye out. That being said, I probably will wrap up before we do the gunfight. Just so I can go get something to eat. I haven't eaten anything today so far, and I probably should. So. I'm working on the railroad. I feel like a third of this stream has just been me slowly walking while over encumbered. Hi, friend.
You looking to buy some supplies?
Chet, you betcha.
Can do.
Damn! That's pretty valuable for a weather pistol. Get rid of that varmint rifle. Why is it worth so much? Okay, so I don't want rads. Rads are bads. So. AP. That might be worth having the reds.
Another satisfied customer. Take it easy.
I wish you can, like, just, you know, back out like you do in Skyrim. Spamming the B button, but see, you have to go all the way down to goodbye just for that. It's just like, it's kind of weird. Breakdown of lead. Breakdown. That's scrap metal to the lead. Twelve gauge. This has no value. I know the cells do have value. So I do need the Abraxo cleaner for shit. God damn it. That's a dog hide? Oh no. Oh. Do I kill Cheyenne for a belt? Do I do that? Oh man. Gecko hide belts. Leather belt, mutt fruit, Nuka Cola. Achievement unlocked, crafty. Nice. Did I get any experience for that? I don't think I did.
You looking to buy some supplies? Can do.
The value at 54, but I'm only gonna get one cap each. That's kind of bull. It's kind of bullshit. We know about the situation with the powder gangers.
If Ringo doesn't head out on his own, I think we should hand him over. The town shouldn't get itself mixed into the problem. Don't mistake that for coward talk, though. We're a town of survivors. We'll fight tooth and nail if pushed. But we don't go looking for trouble. Take it easy now.
Alright. Alright, so I think we're gonna wrap this up. So far we know we got put into a shallow grave. We woke up, got treated by a doctor. We got the NCR and Caesar's Legion. As the two greatest places, like the two greatest factions. And then you have minor factions like Great Khans. Are you inside the damn place? You are inside the damn place. You got the Great Khans. You got powder gangers and a whole bunch of other weirdos.
Hi there, sticking around.
Going to help Ringo tell him powder gangers, and I might need your help.
Say no more. I'm in.
Well, that was easy. Just like that?
Just like that. I have a feeling that I'm going to end up fighting those guys one way or another, so I might as well get it over with. Joe Cobb talks about leaving us alone if we hand over Ringo, but I know his type. He and his friends will come after the town eventually. However, between you, me, and Ringo, we aren't exactly a force to be reckoned with. A lot of people around here look up to Trudy. If you could convince Trudy to join us, some of the folks in town might decide to help out as well. I know Easy Pete's got a stock of dynamite somewhere, and Chet just got a shipment of leather armor we could borrow. Talk to them as well. Finally, there's a good chance we'll all end up with extra holes in us. So if Doc Mitchell could cough up some extra stim packs, that'd be great. A silver tongue would help. Convincing Trudy that we had a good plan to win the fight would also help.
Should be willing to give us the supplies?
I don't think give is in Chet's vocabulary. Even with the town at stake, he'd still make you barter with him.
I can get Easy Pete's dynamite.
Easy Pete's pretty protective of his dynamite. You'd have to convince him you know a thing or two about explosives before he handed it over. I'll be waiting.
Okay.
So you're planning on taking on Joe Cobb's gang. It's a big risk, but I suppose you have to do what you think is right.
Should help me take down the Powder Gang. Bullets, explosions, lots of fun.
I was planning on sitting this one out, but for some reason, I can't help but like you. I'm with you. Let me have a word with a few other folks, and I'll see if I can't round up some more members for this militia you're creating. While everyone does own a gun, we could stand to be a little better equipped. The general store probably has what we need in stock.
Okay.
Be careful out there.
Hey.
Hey. Oh. Hey.
Howdy.
We know about Joe Cobb.
Bad trouble.
That's helpful.
Welcome.
You got dynamite. It'd help us beat the Powder Gangers.
Too dangerous. Gonna kill all yourselves if I let you touch it. Better to leave it buried. Safer that way. Too dangerous. Sorry.
Okay.
Yep.
I need 7 points in explosives, which is gonna be, what, 2 level? No, it's gonna be a level up. Alright. I just gotta find a way to level up. Let's see what Idiot wants for his leather goods. Baby girl! Hi, puppy! Hi.
You looking to buy some supplies?
Need supplies to fight the Powder Gangers.
Now just hold on. I never voted to take on the Powder Gangers. That's a 1,000 cap investment you're talking about. Right. Just keep me out of it.
Alright, I'm 5 short on you.
Take it easy.
So I need 7 in explosives, 5 in barter. Oh, balls. You said to talk to the robot, too. I was already going to talk to the doc, but I'll see the robot, too. What if doc needs, like, 25 in medicine? That'd get annoying, I'm sure. Let's go see the doc. Hey, doc. Hey, I saw your foot.
Welcome back. I had hope you...
The town is going to be attacked by bandits. Anything you could do to help?
Seems like wherever I go, it's always the same. Folks just never leave each other alone. Oh, I'm not much good in a fight with my bum leg.
Nice. Tell me about yourself.
Well, I already told you I came from a vault. After that, I was a traveling doctor for a spell. It seemed like a good idea at the time. Most folks out here ain't educated, so people with medical know-how are hard to come by. I found that I could help a lot of people with what I knew, and that was all right with me. Eventually, I went back and married my childhood sweetheart, and that was the end of my traveling days. Didn't miss it none then. Still don't.
You said before he had something taken from you. I'm guessing it's the wife.
Well, ain't we all, right? That was a long time ago. I don't pay it much mind anymore.
What town is this?
This here's Good Springs, named after the water we got here, just down the road to the southeast. Good Springs Source, they call it. It's a quiet town, and that's how we like it. We don't go looking for trouble, though occasionally it sees fit to come looking for us.
What else can you tell me about Good Spring?
Well, there's a general store just up the road, run by a fella named Chet. He don't got nothing fancy, but he's got your basics covered. If you're looking to wet your whistle, just past Chet's is the Prospector Saloon. The bartender there, Trudy, knows everyone in town. Other than that, there's not much to see. Just people trying to scratch out a living.
Give me a rundown of the Good Springs. Oh, no, I don't need that. Who was it that rescued me?
That'd be Victor. Curious fella. He's sort of odd, and I don't just mean because he's a robot.
I couldn't tell you much about him. He's real friendly, don't get me wrong. You just get the sense that that ain't the whole picture. Just a feeling. He keeps to himself, mostly. You want to know more about him, you'll have to ask him yourself. He has a shack on the southern edge of town. Sure.
I'm hurt.
Don't look like nothing too serious. Let me patch you up. Sutures. Well, if I...
You know anything about the man that shot me?
I didn't see him or the men with him. You might ask around town, though. Could be someone saw which way they was headed. Your best bet would probably be Trudy, the bartender at the saloon up the road. If anyone saw anything, she'd know about it.
All right, goodbye.
You take care now.
Thank you, Doc. All right, so we got the goodies from Doc. Let's go see the Wobot. I need to level up somehow. I get extra experience now. That's a plus. So maybe go kill some coyotes or something. I don't know.
Howdy, partner.
Howdy, partner. Are you decent in a fight? I could use more firepower if you have any.
Trouble with rustlers, huh? Count me in, partner. Those varmints will be running home with their tails between their legs soon enough. Happy trails!
Nice. That was easy. Alright, so explosive and barter. I need enough for both. I need 7 in explosives, 5 in barter. So I need to level up. I need to level up one more time just so I can afford everything. If I knew about the checks, I could have planned out better and had a smoother run of this. But all good. It's all good. Going east will take me over to the new town. I can head north where it says keep out and see if there's anything with decent experience up there. I haven't done a proper save in a while, so let's do a proper save. Yeah. I haven't saved in like an hour and a half, so let's just do a hard save just to be good. I wanna get food. I wonder how fast it's gonna be for me to level up though. I got plenty of vats. If I crouch first with the vats, I might be able to do more headshots. Let's see what's over here. It says keep out, but may have revised character, edit name, rebuild character, finish, travel onward. I could have just redid the character, right? Revised character? Is that what I could have done? And you know what? Nah. I don't regret anything. Let's just go level up. We'll just level up.
You need to be careful.
How y'all was in trouble?
Heck, I can smell trouble a mile away.
Got some trick with the nose.
I like you, friend. Have I mentioned that?
What are you going from me?
I saved your life, so I kind of feel responsible for you is all.
I take care of myself.
Well, sure you can, friend. But everyone needs a hand from time to time. Maybe you'll return the favor one day.
You saying I owe you?
I wouldn't put it exactly like that, friend. Till our trails cross again, partner.
All Okay. You know what? I thought he was a cool robot, but now I'm fucking worried. Oh. Hi. Why can't I aim for the head? I can aim for everything but what I want to, but okay, fine. Oh no, there's poison! Okay, so yeah, that thing hurts quite a bit. Okay. I know. Alright. Alright. So that thing really, really fucked me up. I got a grenade rifle. Lots of worst that could happen, right? Ooh. Okay. Can I? I should just revise my character, right? Rebuild character. Let's go full luck. Actually, no. We want to do strength, right? Maybe throw a little bit. Put 1 point of strength. Ooh, wait. Here is sneak and add explosives. And I got enough points in science now. Melee and arm do more damage. No. Yeah, hoarder. Maybe that's what I need to go with, is just hoarder. Grab that one. +5, but minus 10% experience gain from now on. I'm also smart, so that kind of balances that out. You know what? I'll reset it like this. Let's go with that. Okay. Level 2. Need lockpick 25 to do anything interesting. And we'll let's bring sneak up to 25, I think. Yeah. And then we'll do Swift Learner. Because if I get Swift Learner, that counteracts what I just took for my perk. So now I get more tribute points. And I don't get any experience loss. I'm smart. Did I kill Victor? You know what? All right, yeah, I'm done. I'm just gonna leave this sit here. Oh, I should have saved. All right, I'm gonna get food. I'm not thinking rational. So, thanks guys so much for hanging out. I appreciate it. I'm gonna be playing more of this along with the Skyrim mage build on. I'm gonna do Skyrim Legendary Mage, and I'm gonna play Fallout New Vegas, probably interchangeably over the next couple streams, just to have something different, you know, break it up a little bit. I didn't play much Fallout New Vegas at all when I tested it last night, and I'm kind of glad because it feels like a very fresh, very new game, and I love this. So I know it's been out for a great many years, but you know, it feels nice to have a new game world to get into and explore and be part of, so. That being said, if you're not subscribed, please do so. Everything helps, as you can expect. And don't forget to hit the like button, you know? But anyways, thanks guys so much for hanging out with me. I will see you probably tomorrow or the day after. Bye-bye.